Today on the Healthy Lifestyle Show, I am talking with Marlo Anderson of the National Day Calendar. He is the founder of the National Day Calendar, and stay tuned for this Motivation Monday. Welcome to Happy Trails Hiking. On this station, you will find content focused on park travel as well as living a healthy lifestyle. My name is Kay, and this is the Healthy Lifestyle Show. On this show, I want to offer you encouragement to live the life you love. This is Motivation Monday. Let me encourage you to use that hashtag on your social media posts today. I would love to retweet and share things that motivate you today. Please feel free to tag me on Twitter at Happy Trails Hike or on Facebook and Instagram at Happy Trails Hiking. I would like to say good morning to the chat. Before we get started today, Life on the Trail, Gary, it's good to see you, as well as Deb Shane. And Food Force Permaculture, Howie, it's awesome to have you. Mom of Four is here. Thank you. Lori Bryant, Karen Summers with a Splash Raid. Thanks for coming, Karen. Outdoor Nomad is here. And Panic Deep Paranormal History is here. And Desmond Stonders, as well as Susan's Creative and Chandra Paivo. It's awesome to have all of you here today. Our show today is brought to you by our photography store. And you can find those photos that can go on mugs and lovely photos and collages for your walls at happytrailshiking.com/store. All right, guys. As I mentioned at the start of the show, our guest today is Marlo Anderson. And he is a serial entrepreneur and futurist and is best known for being the founder of the National Day Calendar, trending over 450 times last year with a daily average social media reach in the hundreds of millions. National Day Calendar is the most popular trending topic of all time. National Day Calendar is followed daily by more than 20,000 media outlets, including Elvis Duran, Ellen DeGeneres, Fox and Friends, and Good Morning America. Marlo's direct online following now numbers over 12 million people. He has appeared in most major newspapers, from the Wall Street Journal to the Fargo Forum. He's appeared many times on national news programs and in many magazines, including Time and Entrepreneur. This social media phenomenon is also the host of a radio talk show, The Tech Ranch, and affectionately known to his followers as the Guru of Geek. This unique platform has given Marlo firsthand knowledge in emerging technology trends and hardware. With a passion for startups, Marlo has been directly involved in the creation of Package, Talking Trail, Zuvio, Awesome 2 Products, 365, and National Day Calendar. His community projects include 1 Million Cups ND, the North Dakota Automated Vehicle Collaborative, the Old 10 Scenic Byway, North Dakota Music Hall of Fame, and the Mandan Independence Day Parade, to name just a few. Marlo resides in Mandan, North Dakota. Welcome, Marlo. It is awesome to see you today. Thank you for being here.
Hey, Kay, it's my pleasure to be here. It's such a fantastic day.
Oh, it is a good day, and I'm thrilled to have you. For those of you who don't know, I met Marlo up in North Dakota in Medora at the Midwest Travel Conference, and he was one of our keynote speakers there, and I'm just honored that he wanted to come and hang out with us for a little while for Motivation Monday. If you have any questions for Marlo, can you please type at Happy Trails Hiking in your questions so that I can see it? And if you don't mind, can you share this out so that other people can see the wonderfulness that is Marlo Anderson today? Anyway, I know we have a short period of time because you have a show to do this afternoon.
I do, yeah.
In an hour or so. So I just wanted to get started. Let's get started with our questions. So how did your company get started? How did National Day Calendar come about?
Wow. Well, I'll try to give you, I know, the short answer to, this is actually a long story. I know you were privy of that at the Travel Writers, but basically had this idea about you know, writing about National Days, how they came to be, because there really wasn't anything, you know, about 6.5 years ago when we started this project on where the National Days came to be. You know, how did National Popcorn Day get started? And I was shocked by that. I'm a tech person. I was really surprised that there wasn't like a Wikipedia of where these National Days came from. So recruited a friend of mine. We started to write about these days. And basically, we're kind of shocked that other people started to follow this. And that's kind of how it came to be. Probably, and it was just a hobby. So the first 2.5 years was just a hobby. The friend I recruited after 6 months actually left the project because she couldn't handle the pressure of it anymore. It was supposed to be a fun project, and it still is. Mm-hmm. But she had challenges with the pressure of the media that were starting to follow us. And we had to get that story out at a certain time, or we'd start getting these emails coming in about where the story is so they could prep for tomorrow's shows across the country. So, so for the next 2 years, that's what I did is work and on my nights and weekends, writing, trying, you know, investigating everything from the Smithsonian to the Library of Congress. I mean, all of this information, old newspapers, trying to come up with where these days came from and were the, and, you know, places where we didn't maybe have days just to talk about them a little bit, because I always wanted to have something to write about every day. And so anyway, and then I was at a tech conference and I was hosting a panel on transportation. And during that course, and I promise you, this will get to back to National Day calendar. Just kind of this roundabout way. But I had mentioned during this panel discussion that Highway 83, which is a road that runs north and south through the middle of the country, longest contiguous road in the United States. And I mentioned that this should be an autonomous friendly corridor that we could start testing self-driving vehicles and that type of thing. And there's a reporter in the room. She wrote about this thing. And the next thing you know, I'm front page news across the country. It got picked up by the AP. And I had all of these requests coming in for stories. Well, Fox News calls and says, you know, they'd like to interview me. And I'm like, yeah, absolutely. And we hop on to Skype and I'm live on national news and we're talking. She's like, how did you come up with this idea? And I start talking about how the country was founded east to west. So our roads run east and west and our rail runs east and west. And especially in the middle part of the country, it's tough to move north and south and the economies of that and all of this stuff I'm talking about. And after about 2 minutes, she stops me and she goes, so what does this have to do with National Puppy Day? And I'm like, you know, again, I'm on national live on national news. And all I could think of was I just went like this, put my other hat on, and we started to talk about National Puppy Day. But after I left that interview, I was like, what have I created with this? And had a meeting with my staff because it was already very disruptive. Mm-hmm. And we just decided either this had to go away or we had to spin this into a business because it had to support itself. So we spun it into a business at that time. So National Day calendar isn't even 5 years old yet. Wow. And we're still figuring it out. I mean, we you know, we didn't have a business plan when we started this business. It was just one of those things that came to be because of you. I mean, that's the best way I can say that.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. It's an amazing story. And I love that. And like I said, it's so motivating. And that's why I had to have you for Motivation Monday. So it just came about because people wanted it. You feel the need, and that's awesome. And I think that's what all of us as like social media entrepreneurs and YouTubers are interested in knowing about. So that is awesome. So what are the most popular days? You mentioned National Puppy Day, but right. So what are the most popular days that you get the most retweets?
Yeah. So pet days are popular. Most of them are, you know, dog day, cat day, what have you. Sure. But family days seem to be the more popular of that. So like National Siblings Day, Sons and Daughters Day, those type of days do very, very well. And then there's like Sunglasses Day. Sunglasses Day does very well. I think you get people like Tom Cruise who put on, you know, sunglasses and then tweet about it. And then everybody starts to push that stuff out. So that day actually has a reach of over 1.2 billion people, which is incredible.
That's amazing.
It's amazing, right? There's actually about a dozen national days, including like Siblings Day, Coffee Day, which was yesterday.
Cheers to that.
Big deal. There you go. I was at my favorite coffee joint yesterday morning, and the line was to the door the entire time I was there. You know, so Coffee Day does well. Pizza Day does well. A lot of the bigger food type of things do very well too.
Yeah. So speaking of National Coffee Day, we are celebrating it on Midwest Monday Chat on Twitter today. So if anybody wants to throw in their favorite coffee joint they went to yesterday, I would love to see where that is. Anyway, we've got a great room here today. Everybody, thank you for coming. For those who might have just hopped in, this is Marlo Anderson, and he's the founder of the National Day Calendar, as well as runs a thetechranch.com. And so I'm very excited to be talking to him today. If you have any questions, please make sure to stick those in the chat for me. And I do have some questions that are kind of follow-up to most popular days that came from the community members. So in a follow-up to the most popular day, the Outdoor Nomad wants to know, are there any days on the calendar that are not something days, or is every day filled?
So every day is full. There are a couple days that just have one national day on them, but we do have about 1,500 national days. Oh. And some of them are static. So if it's September 30th, they're on here, but it also could be the last Friday of the month. So sometimes you'll have days, you get this weird combination of days sometimes that might not even make any sense. Like we'll have National Vegan Day on the same day as National Hamburger Day.
Oh,
simply because I know it's crazy. Simply because one is a static and one kind of floats around. So you just kind of get those days. And so that's actually kind of fun, and people have a good time with that, of course.
Nice. Howie from Food Forest Permaculture is asking, is there a green juice day?
There is a green juice day. We worked with Starbucks with that about 2 years ago. I don't remember the actual the day that it falls on, but we do have a green juice day.
Yep. Okay. And I would assume that people could go to National Day Calendar and search for their day, if they wanted to know. Okay. Got it.
Absolutely. There's a search feature right on the website for that. Yep.
All right. Yes. Awesome. The next question I had from someone else is Yankees Outdoor Adventure wanted to know, how does a day become a day? I know there's a form, but what's the process for that?
So when you said Yankees, I'm a Twins fan, and I'm thinking that maybe that person wanted to know my prediction for the Yankees and Twins. I'm going to say Twins, of course.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go. And Yankees probably doesn't care about baseball at all, but that's okay.
So in the old days, the national days came about simply, the way they came about is as varied as the days are themselves. So nowadays we have a streamlined process where you hop online, you fill out a form. We have a committee of four people that go through them. And if you're lucky enough, we have about 25,000 applications a year right now. And just a handful of those actually make it through the committee. It has to be a unanimous vote for that national day. That's how it works nowadays. However, back in the day, so to speak, Congress did a lot of this, Hallmark, believe it or not, they actually brought out a lot of the national days that we have now, like Mother's Day and those type of things that are on the calendar. So, and of course, if there are dates that fall into some of these things, like Christmas and the 4th of July, Independence Day, Thanksgiving, those all came about generally because of our Congress. So.
Okay. Well, there you go. That is awesome. And Lori Bryant, who is one of my moderators and my sister, says that Green Juice Day is January 26th.
Thank you very much.
She's my awesome human Google is what I call her. She's really good at searching things really fast. Chandra Pivo is interested in a disability day. Chandra, I will look that up for you after and get back to you. But thank you for asking questions. So that's awesome. I think we could probably spend all day here going, okay, well, what's this day? What's this day? What's this day? And yeah, that That's why we have the database, right, Marlo?
That's exactly so right. Go look it up. Exactly.
Don't have to remember everything because I don't know about you, but I'm not so good. I have to write it down.
And it's funny since I don't write everything now. I think, you know, even 3 or 4 years ago, I was able to pretty much rattle off all the national days because I wrote them, you know.
Sure.
But as you said, you know, if you don't practice it, then you kind of it goes the other way. But generally, I can still tell you if there's a national day or not. But I'm not actually sure about the National Disabilities Day. That's a very interesting question. If there isn't one, we should have one. Actually,
we should
That's
have one. Chandra, you should submit for that. That would be awesome.
Yes, absolutely.
And Timey Lives is asking me what today is, and so it's Chewing Gum Day, Hot Mold Cider Day, Love People Day, Mud Pack Day, and Save Your Photos Day. So all you YouTubers out there, save your photos. And I know this because I have a 2019 version of the National Day Calendar, and it is what I have up here, right here, next to my desk. So, yes, and you can get your 2020, you can pre-order for the 2020 calendar right now on
You can actually hop on our website and do that. Actually, they actually showed up on Friday. We have many pallets of calendars that showed up. That's my whole team is working diligently to get those orders out right now. So if you were to order, you'd get your 2020 in the next week or so.
That's cool. That's very cool. I love this. I'm just sitting there and I can look and see what day it is, and people, and I'll know, like, I'll be in the know really fast. I don't have to wait for the blog to come.
And of course, it gives you something to blog about or tweet about or whatever.
Share photos about. Yes.
Yep. We actually had a team that came in and actually did a study on this, where if you were to say for your business or for your blog or whatever, that come on down to the shop and get free donuts today, you will have this amount of engagement, right? If you say it's National Donut Day, come on down and get your free donuts, you'll have an over 300% more engagement simply because you stated it's National Donut Day. It's crazy the engagement that you'll get when you use national days.
And Chandra Pivo says it's a clever way to create ways for people to spend more money, boost the economy. People will spend more money on their favorite days. Do you find that's true?
It is true. And just like my experience yesterday with National Coffee Day, the Wall Street Journal actually did a story on us about a year and a half ago. And that was the premise of the story, how National Day actually affects the national economy.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Well, that's awesome. I mean, thanks for that. We appreciate it.
One more thing to spend money on, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, got to boost the economy somehow. Right. Let's see. So my next question comes from a channel and a gentleman called Inspired John, and he'd like to know what you think the weirdest day is. Do you have a weird, this is the weirdest day I've ever heard of, but I love it, or?
So I probably can't mention any of the suggested national days that we get in, but I would say there are two of them. One of them isn't as popular as the other. So, Nude Gardening Day, I think, is interesting, and that's been around for a little while.
Okay.
The other one that is actually really, really popular is Sneak Some Zucchini on Your Neighbor's Porch Day.
Okay.
And I love that day because if you actually grow zucchini, you know what I'm talking about. You cannot get this stuff under control. You'll plant two plants, and you'll have enough to feed, you know, the entire neighborhood. So why not just sneak some on everybody's neighbor's porch and.
There you go. That wasn't too long ago either. It was like August or early September.
Yeah. Yep. Exactly. Yep.
Yeah. That's a good time to put zucchini on other people's.
Of course.
You end up with most of that. So, and then Riverette Skippy says we need a free boat motor day. Yeah, I want free stuff too. Hey, it's boat motor day. Come on down and get your free boat motor.
Well, let's go for free car day then too. I'd love that.
Yes, or free RV day. I'm down for that. Or so. And then the last community question I have is from Pusha Studios, and they were my Motivation Monday from last week. But they'd like to know what your favorite day is and why.
So I have two of them. So my original favorite national day is National Popcorn Day. I love popcorn, have my entire life. And I'm, you know, if there's popcorn in a shop, when I go in there, that's the first thing I kind of gravitate to. And that was the day that National Day calendar started. So January 19th, 2013 is National Popcorn Day. But since then, you know, we've declared quite a few new national days. And I think my new, wow, there's another one that just popped up that I really like too, but National Astronaut Day. I really enjoy that, the first part of May. And because of National Astronaut Day, we were able to declare that at the Space Symposium in Colorado Springs a couple of years ago. So I was able to meet a lot of astronauts, and some of them become my friends now. So I kind of really enjoy that. A new national day this year is Road Trip Day. And I love road tripping. And that may actually get in front of, I don't know, I got the geek side of me going off on one side, and I got this travel experience thing going off on the other side. So I'm not sure which of those two will end up being my favorite, but they're both in good contention for being.
Those are awesome days. Yeah. So, well, I got to talk to Marlo for just a second before we got started. So speaking of astronauts and things, as a futurist and tech guy, what are big things that are coming up? What should we look for from you for in the future?
Well, you know, for us, we are actually, we just signed a deal for a national radio show. So coming soon to a radio station near you, you'll be hearing the National Day Calendar daily update. Yeah. If you're familiar with Paul Harvey, it's very Paul Harvey-esque. We'll be telling kind of the rest of the story on how the national days came to be, as well as kind of a cool twist at the end with a hero. So we're going to be, you know, we're going to tie the national days to maybe a story that you've never heard about before. And, you know, we were in the studio just a couple of days ago to start getting ready. We actually start recording next month. And we'll be beta testing the show on 15 stations from November to the first of the year. Awesome. And then the first week of February, it'll launch nationally. So, yeah, pretty excited about that.
That is really cool. I love the national hero. That's just really, that's just
inspiring. Yeah, and I have to say that the team that's working on this, I mean, it's sometimes tough to read these stories because they get pretty emotional. I mean, and you know, you were at my talk. I mean, yes. Some of these stories that we get in sometimes are extremely emotional. I've never actually brought a whole room to tears before. That was kind of, even the grown men in the room at the travel writers conference were crying from that letter. It was an amazing letter. But the point is that you never know the people you're going to impact, right? I mean, you know, just going off our copy this morning, you just don't know who you're going to run into and the kind of day they're having and the impact that you can have. Just the simple act of saying thank you and please can really have a profound impact on the other person.
Totally.
Because you just don't know what the last phone call they got was or what have you. So I think the thing I like about National Days is that it brings people together. It creates a kinder world, I think. And I'm profoundly thankful for the movement that has been created around National Days.
I'm thankful for the kinder world that you are creating. That's one of my big things is you can always be kind. You can always be kind.
Always.
And I think the world needs to be kinder to one another, you know?
Right.
You were mentioning people and the National Day calendar actually is about connecting people, and that's really cool. What kind of people have you met across your social media phenomena here? Who have you met that you will never forget?
Wow. You know, I've met a lot of people. There's no doubt about it. You know, National Coffee Day 2 years ago, I actually worked with a group of people and we just went out on the streets of a major city and served coffee to homeless people. And I had quite a few conversations with, the homeless, in that particular town. And that was significantly eye-opening. The reasons that people end up homeless are not, you know, a lot of it is drugs, and some people choose the lifestyle, but not everybody is there on purpose, you know. So it was interesting to hear those stories, you know, and I've met the president, you know. So, I mean, it goes, I've been and everywhere in between. I mean, I've ended up being on some national TV shows, you know, pretty much every major news network across the country, you know. So I've met a lot of interesting people over the course of this. Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, I love the slogan, celebrate every day.
Thank you.
And I think that I am motivated by the fact that you give people a reason to celebrate every day, because many people can find so many reasons to not celebrate today,
right.
You know, yeah. And I love that. So thank you for that slogan as well. This is Motivation Monday. And since it's Motivation Monday, I always like to ask, who motivates you?
Wow. I would have to say our following. You know, if it wasn't for our following, National Day would not be what it is today. I mean, the one thing I learned about through the whole process is the value of consistency. And we were actually forced to be consistent. You know, tomorrow's a new national day. We had to write about it. It didn't matter what we had to go through to get that article out. But that brought a whole new appreciation to, you know, the following that we have. And I would have to say that the following behind National Day Calendar motivates me. And it's, you know, I get hundreds of emails and news and actual written letters every day. It's very moving and wow.
Yeah.
And touches me deep profoundly. So.
Wow. Yeah. I always say that the people who come back and leave comments for our videos, be it a live stream or an edited video that we put out or a review, those are the people who motivate me to do better every day. And I would
sure. say
that's what you're getting too, is you get it in a different way, but not always either. You get letters and I get comments in the comment
sure.
section. And I think that's totally true. I'm motivated by my audience and the folks that come in chat every day and see what we're doing here on the Healthy Lifestyle Show and on Happy Trails Hiking. So, I think that's all of my questions for the day.
Okay.
I just so appreciate you being on and appreciate you being in my life. I'm very happy that I met you this year, and you make a difference and a good difference in people's lives.
It was certainly a pleasure of mine meeting you in Medora, North Dakota. I'm going to throw that out there real quick. We need to go to the best hidden secret in the United States. It is Medora, in my opinion.
I would agree. I fell in love with Medora, North Dakota. And if it didn't snow so much up there, I might move there I loved it there. It was amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing.
North Dakota's got lots of hidden gems up there. So everybody should head up there and check it out. But if you'll hang out for just a second, I'll close out the show. Thank you so much for being here today, Marlo.
Thanks. Hey, have a great day, everybody.
All right. Thanks. All right, everybody. Thank you for joining in the chat today and meeting Marlo Anderson from the National Day Calendar. His links are below in the description. And I want you to do three things for me today. One, if you enjoyed the content of this show and think someone else would enjoy it, please share it personally with them. And two, make sure that you go over and say hello to Marlo on the blog and tell him you found him through Happy Trails Hiking. And three, go out and live the life you love today. And remember, you are not replaceable. I'm so happy that you spent this time with me today, and I will see you tomorrow for Travel Tuesday.